fitfully praise that fancy loves. I praise and love that child whose heart no thought, whose tongue no word, whose hand no deed defiled. I praise him most, I love him best. All praise and love is his. While him I love, in him I live, and cannot live amiss. Love's sweetest mark, man's highest theme, man's most desired light. To love him life, to leave him death, to live in him delight. He mine by gift, I his by debt, thus each to other due. First friend he was, best friend he is, all times will try him true. Though young yet wise, though small yet strong, though man yet God he is, as wise he knows, as strong he can, as God he loves to bless. His knowledge rules, his strength defends, his love doth cherish all. His birth our joy, his life our light, his death our end of thrall. Doth bud a joyful spring. Oh, bonny prince, whose tender arms can force all foes to fly. Correct my faults, protect my life, direct me when I die. Correct my faults, protect my life, direct me when I die.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
By the Immaculate Conception, O Mary, make my body pure and my soul holy. My Mother, preserve me this night from mortal sin. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
By the Immaculate Conception, O Mary, make my body pure and my soul holy. My Mother, preserve me this night from mortal sin. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
By the Immaculate Conception, O Mary, make my body pure and my soul holy. my mother preserve me this night from mortal sin. Good afternoon. It's today, Tuesday, the 13th of April, 2021. And today is the feast of Saint Hermenegild. From today's Roman Martyrology. At Sevilla in Spain, Saint Hermenegild, son of Leovigild, Arian king of the Visigoths, who was imprisoned for the confession of the Catholic faith. By order of his wicked father, he was beheaded because he had refused to receive communion from an Arian bishop on the feast of Easter. Thus, exchanging an earthly for an heavenly kingdom, he entered the abode of the saints, both as a king and as a martyr. And in other places, many other holy martyrs, confessors and virgins. Today is Tuesday, and this day is kept in honor of the Blessed Infant Jesus. And tomorrow is Wednesday, and kept in honor of Saint Joseph. Dear soul, heartily welcome to the broadcasting of the Transylvanian Redemptorist, the Sons of the Most Holy Redeemer, from the holy island of Papas Tronse, in the Diocese of Aberdeen in Scotland. May God bless you abundantly with his blessing of divine and holy love. Thank you for staying with us, despite the sometimes bad internet connection, which problems are caused by the satellite service we depend on, living on a remote island. We do what we can to solve this technical issue, but we cannot avoid getting cut short. If the broadcast should cut short today, please do come back tomorrow and we'll try again. From the glories of Mary, by our Holy Father Saint Alphonsus. Chapter 4, To Thee Do We Cry, Probenus Children of Eve. Section 1, On the Promptitude of Mary, in assisting those who invoke her. Nor should the multitude of our sins diminish our confidence that Mary will grant our petitions when we cast ourselves at her feet. She is the mother of mercy, but mercy would not be needed did none exist who require it. On this subject, Richard of St. Lawrence remarks that as a good mother does not shrink from applying a remedy to her child infected with ulcers, however nauseous and revolting they may be, so also is our good mother unable to abandon us when we have recourse to her, that she may heal the wounds caused by our sins, however loathsome they may have rendered us. This is exactly what Mary gave Saint Gertrude to understand when she showed herself to her with her mantle spread out to receive all who have recourse to her. At the same time, the saint was told that angels constantly guard the clients of this blessed virgin from the assaults of hell. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Today is Tuesday, and on this date of reading is taken from the incarnation, birth and infancy of Jesus Christ by our Holy Father, Saint Alphonsus. The Mysteries of Faith, the Incarnation, Discourses for the Novena of Christmas. Discourse 2, the Eternal Word, being great becomes little. A child is born to us, and a son is given to us. Plato said that love is the lodestone of love. Hence comes the common proverb, as St. John Chrysostom remarks, "If you wish to be loved, love." For certainly there is no more effectual means to secure for one's self the affection of another than to love him, and to make him aware that he is loved. But, my Jesus, this rule, this proverb, holds good for others, holds good for all, but not for thee. Men are grateful to all, but not to thee. Thou art at a loss what further to do to show men the love thou bearest them. Thou hast positively nothing more to do to allure the affection of men. Yet in point of fact, how many are there among mankind who love thee? Alas, the greatest number, we may say nearly all, not only do not love thee, but they offend thee and despise thee. And shall we stand in the ranks of these heartless wretches? God has not earned this at our hands, that God, so good, so tender of us, who being great and of infinite greatness, has thought fit to make himself little in order to be loved by us. Let us seek light from Jesus and Mary. To compose the idea of the immense love of God to man, in becoming himself a man and a feeble child for our love, it would be necessary to comprehend his greatness. But what mind of man or angel can conceive the greatness of God, which is indeed infinite? The one who should be loved the most, who deserves most our love, is often loved so little. Let us do our best to love him as much as we can. Dear soul, you are cordially invited to unite yourselves with us to pray in the here and now. The goal of the live streaming is further to communicate the teachings of the Catholic Church, including those of our Holy Father, Saint Alphonsus. The form of today, first hour, notices and Holy Rosary, and in the half hour after it, Saint Patrick's Breastplate, the Exorcism, and after that, devotions. So today we continue the last part of the story of the life of Saint Margaret of Cortona. She was getting more and more at the end of her life. She now longed to die and to be admitted in heaven. She redoubled her prayers for this grace. Our Lord at length revealed to her the day and the hour of her death. He told her that she would not ascend alone to a heavenly country, but that she would be escorted by a numerous band of souls delivered from purgatory through her intercession. And that is where we stayed last time. From that time, her strength began to decay, and she passed 17 days without any other food but the Holy Eucharist. On the eve of her death, Father Giunta gave her extreme unction. At daybreak on the morrow, she received the last absolution and the Holy Viaticum. And then Margaret fell asleep in the peace of the Lord Jesus. A holy person saw a soul going up to heaven, accompanied by a number of souls freed from purgatory through her merit. She died on the 22nd of February 1297 at the age of 50. She had then done 23 years of penance. When her death became known, the people of Cortona came to venerate her body, because they felt what they had lost in the death of this poor and humble woman. All with one voice extolled her merits and praised her. She was buried in the church of St. Basil, where her tomb was glorified by numerous miracles. Among these miracles were 12 dead persons raised to life. A few words about how people did venerate her. The same year that she died, the citizens of Cortona agreed to build a church in honor of her. This church was erected on a site near the oratory of St. Basil. St. Bernardine of Siena installed in the church in honor of St. Margaret the convent of the friars of the observance, together with the custody of the tomb of St. Margaret. And this occurred in the year 1433. And thus the Franciscans of the observance have had the guardianship of the famous sanctuary of St. Margaret for nearly 5 centuries. This was fulfilled what our Lord said to St. Margaret: as to thy burial, thy will has already been made. I have bequeathed thee entirely to the care of the friars minor, and to thy holy guardianship. I confide thee and give thee again to the order of my beloved Francis. I will have thee belong to him after death, no less than in life. But this prophecy of our Lord was not fulfilled until a century after her death. Our Lord had in fact revealed to her that the church where her body was to be buried would not be given to the friars minor till after a long time. Towards the year 1456, the saint's body was taken up and found to be incorrupt. So it was almost 60 years after her death. It was then translated from the oratory of St. Basil to the sanctuary of the new church. One placed it behind the high altar again more than a century later, where it still reposes. And St. Margaret was solemnly canonized by Pope Benedict XIII in the year 1728. Pope Alexander VII in 1660 approved the confraternity in St. Margaret's honor, which was called the Confraternity of Penance. And Pope Benedict the 14th in 1748, enriched it with new indulgences, and erected it into an arts fraternity. Let us then invoke St. Margaret with confidence, since our Lord himself has deigned to reveal us her glory and the power of her intercession. For the Junta tells us that Jesus Christ showed St. Margaret a throne of dazzling splendor among the seraphim, telling her that this throne was prepared for her. And another time Jesus said to her, "Thou art a rose, white by thy innocence, and red by thy love. Whatever thou shalt ask my Father in my name shall be granted to thee, and those who have recourse to thee shall receive a special grace." We have seen that St. Margaret's love for God was indeed very great. Our Lord said to her, "My child, ask me whatever thou desirest." And Margaret answered, "Lord, I ask for nothing else but to love thee always, to serve thee, and never to offend thy divine majesty." And further, our Lord said to her, "I will never grant to anyone the gifts of my grace, but on condition that he deny himself and take up his cross to follow me, as I have expressly taught in my gospel." In conclusion, let us not forget our Lord's recommendation to his friends through St. Margaret to weep first over their own sins, then over his sorrowful passion, and lastly over poor sinners who lose their souls by offending him. If we did that, we nourish within ourselves the spirit of compunction. Not many devout persons do that, and yet it is the root of humility and an indispensable virtue. And as Saint Bernardine of Siena says, it draws divine grace into our hearts as the lodestone attracts iron. We have now come to the end of the story of the life of St. Margaret of Cortona.
Let folly praise that fancy loves, I praise and love that child, whose heart no thought, whose tongue no word, whose hand no deed defiled. I praise him most, I love him best, all praise and love is his. While him I love, in him I live, and cannot live amiss. Love's sweetest mark, man's highest theme, man's most desired life. Though man, yet God he is. As strong he can, as God he loves to bless. His knowledge rules, his strength defends, his love doth cherish all. His birth for joy, his life for light, his never end of thrall. Doth bud a joyful spring.